Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you a quick way to create a dramatic red and blue face portrait. If you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, hit the subscribe button at the lower right. Open a high-resolution photo of a face that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from dreamstime.com. You'll get the best results if your subject is facing forward and is dramatically lit from both sides of the face. It'll also look best if your subject is on a black background. If it isn't, make a selection around your subject so you can separate it from its background. There are many ways to do this, and I covered them all in my previous tutorials, so to save time, I won't be going over them here. Even though this subject is already on a black background, I made a selection around it to show you what to do next. Once you make the selection around your subject, click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to it. Make a new layer below it by control-clicking or command-clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with black, but first, check your foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since black is your foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. We'll convert our image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, shift-click the top layer to make it active as well, and open the flyout list. Click Convert to Smart Object. Make two copies of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Name the bottom layer Red, the middle layer Blue, and the top layer Overlay. Click the eyeball icons next to the overlay layer and the blue layer to temporarily hide them, and make the red layer active. Double-click an empty area next to it to open its layer style window. In Advanced Blending, uncheck the green and blue channels. We'll convert this into a smart object, which will show our red image as a layer. To do this, click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Shift-click the red layer to make it active as well, and click the icon at the upper right corner. Click Convert to Smart Object. Now, our red layer is truly red. Temporarily hide the layer and make the middle layer visible. Double-click an empty area of this layer to open its layer style window and uncheck the red channel. We'll convert this into a smart object as well. Make a new layer. Shift-click the blue layer and convert them into one smart object. We now see a blue layer. Make the red layer visible and make the top layer visible and active. Change its blend mode to overlay and reduce its opacity to 50%. Make the blue layer active and click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to it. Open your gradient tool and make sure the linear gradient icon is active. Open your gradient thumbnails and click the black and white thumbnail. Place your cursor on the left cheek and press and hold the shift key as you drag the tool to the right cheek, then release. Lastly, we'll add a filter that'll make our portrait sharper, brighter, and give it a bit of texture. To do this, first, we'll convert all the layers into a smart object. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Artistic folder and click Paint Daubs. Make the brush size 1, the sharpness 14, and the brush type Simple. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.